Dear student, welcome to this lecture on the topic metals and non-metals in organic synthesis. We have seen so far mercury, boron, silicon and tin. Now we will look into the last topic of this unit, that is selenium in organic synthesis. The use of selenium in carrying out different organic reactions so that we can design and synthesize our desired organic compounds using selenium. Selenium is one of the toxic materials, but still we can use it carefully so that it can be used for our synthesis of desired organic compounds here.
So organoselenium compounds, first we will see about the synthesis. Synthesis can be carried out in different ways. We can have first from alkyl halides, can be reacted with sodium selenide to give us dialkyl diselenide plus 2. This can be cleaved by using reducing agents like NaBH4, to give us selenols. 2 moles of selenols can be formed, alkyl selenols. Similarly, it can also be reacted with the silyl chloride. Can also be reacted with, say, benzene in Lewis acid catalyst to give us this particular cation. Which can be heated at 230 degrees Celsius to give us plus chlorobenzene. Third reaction can be FeBr4 reacted with organomercury compounds to give us alkyl diselenide. Alkyl halides, here we are having bromine, so alkyl bromide and organomercury bromide. Fourth way is the hydrogen selenide. When reacted with an epoxide, give us the selenol alcohol can be formed. The reference books for this organotin as well as for selenide is Karyn-Sundberg et part B, as these both topics, organopin as well as organoselenides, are present in it. So you can refer these things. Here we will be taking up the general reactions for this organoselenols, general reactions. First is alkyl selenol can be subjected to basic reaction under basic conditions, either NaOH or sodium ethoxide. We'll extract this proton or hydrogen from the air. Generate a salt. If this is reacted with alkyl halide, we will get dialkyl selenide. Similarly, we can have two further reactions. One is with lactones. And another one with epoxides. With lactones, it will be a ring opening reaction. This now we will get over here, and that will be ring will be opened with this carbon oxygen bond cleavage. And with the epoxide, again similar to what we have seen it just now, we will get this alkyl selenol can be obtained. Second reaction for this is elimination of selenoxides. Elimination of selenoxides can be carried out. This particular reaction was elimination of selenoxide. In this, what we are doing is epoxide when reacts with selenium salt, it will be giving us this selenol, and then upon oxidation using hydrogen peroxide, it will form a selenoxide. This selenoxide undergoes elimination to form a selenoxide hydride, and we'll get an alpha beta unsaturated alcohol. Similarly, we can do other type of reactions also. Like if we have OH over here, and the selenide, this selenide will undergo elimination of this hydroxide group as well as this selenium compound. So it will be giving us cyclohexene instead of alpha beta unsaturated alcohol. This will undergo protonation to form a good leaving group. There can be formation of cyclohexene. Instead of losing a proton from here, the other side of the carbon, we will be losing hydroxide from here because it is not a oxidized. Selenoxide hota to yahan se proton jata tha ya idhar ka hydroxide. से प्रोटॉन जाता था. सो इनॉल बनता है या फिर अल्फा बीटा अनसैचुरेटेड अल्कोहल बनता है. बट ये सिलिन ऑक्साइड नहीं है तो हमें इस टाइप का रिएक्शन मिलेगा. Here the difference between the two is that in this selenium is a donor of electron, while in silicon oxide selenium is an acceptor of electron. So it is we can say that this is type of an Umbelong effect that has happened. Umbelong effect mein kya hota hai? You have in next semester you will be studying this Umbelong effect. Umbelong effect mein hum पर्टिकुलर एटम का जो चार्ज होता है उसको हम रिवर्स करते हैं. लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू हैव अ कार्बोनिल ग्रुप, कार्बोनिल में कार्बन का डेल्टा पॉजिटिव चार्ज होता है. कार्बोनिल में कार्बन का हमारा डेल्टा पॉजिटिव होता है एंड ऑक्सीजन इज अ डेल्टा नेगेटिव चार्ज. तो इन उम्पोलोंग इफेक्ट बाय यूजिंग सर्टेन रिएजेंट्स वी कैन चेंज और रिवर्स दिस चार्ज ऑफ कार्बोनिल कार्बन फ्रॉम अ delta positive to delta negative. So being an electrophilic, it will now become a nucleophile, a mild nucleophile, and then it can undergo a different reaction. This particular strategy, or this by using this effect, we can carry out many different types of reaction. So that you will be studying in next semester about this Umbelong effect. ये organic synthesis में काफी काम में आता है. यहाँ पे हमारा Umbelong इफेक्ट सिलेनियम पे हो रहा है. अगर हम सिलिन ऑक्साइड करते हैं उसका, तो जो सिलेनियम है दैट बिकम्स एन इलेक्ट्रोफाइल इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक, एंड ऐसे ही अगर सिलिनाइड होगा तो इट विल बी अ न्यूक्लियोफिलिक. तो इट विल बी लूजिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, नॉट ए न्यूक्लियोफिलिक, बट इट विल बी डोनर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. हियर इट विल बी एन एक्सेप्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शंस कैन बी फॉलोड बाय दिस पर्टिकुलर रूल. Now, if this cyclohexanone subjected to LDA, it will be giving us enol. This enol, when subjected to diselenide, reaction with diselenide, will be giving us this particular atoms. Similarly, we can undergo different other reactions also. Okay. Lactone is present. Trans lactone, trans because the two hydrogens here, the two cycle rings are trans to each other. So when LDA followed by diselenide, first we will be just taking up. Only LDA, and then in the second step we can react it with diselenide. this further oxidation using hydrogen peroxide will form a silane oxide. This undergoes an elimination reaction, preferably for formation of an hexacyclic double bond. Unsaturated hexacyclic double bond can be introduced in this particular compound. यहाँ पे नहीं तो दो hydrogens eliminate नहीं हो सकते हैं, लेकिन वो दो hydrogens हम यहाँ पे अगर eliminate करना हो, effectively it is just the loss of this hydrogen and loss of one of the hydrogens from methyl group. So that can be carried out via this particular synthesis. So this is one of the applications of selenium organoselenium reactions. Organic synthesis. Similarly, the selene oxides can act as an activating group also. Here, if we have a phenyl methyl selenide, it will be reacting with H2O2 to form selene oxide. This, when subjected to LDA, will be losing a proton from here. And if it is subjected to reaction with alkyl halide or an alpha beta unsaturated alkyl halide like 3-bromopropene, will form a substitution reaction will occur. Now, this undergoes elimination reaction by losing one of the protons from here. Will have CH2 double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH. So 1,3-butadiene can be easily formed. This is homologous homologation reaction where we are increasing the compound original compound by one carbon. That can be done by this methyl group. If you want to increase it by further, then we can join other chains also. More than one carbon alkyl group will be present over here. So that will be leading to different other reactions also. Such reactions can be easily carried out using this particular reaction. Similarly, you can have selenoacetals as precursors for diselenide stabilized carbanions. So for this, if we have a ketone, when reacted with 2 moles of selenides in presence of any Lewis acid, it will be giving us diselenide . This when subjected to basic conditions with N-butyl lithium, this compound we call it as selenoacetals. These are stable to acidic conditions, but in basic conditions, highly basic conditions, they will lose one of the selenide to form carbanion. This carbanion then further be reacted with very many different types of reagents, like for example RCOX, acyl chlorides, or it can react with carbon dioxide, carboxylate. This carboxylate upon hydrolysis will be giving the carboxylic acid. Further, we can react it with alkyl halide. And many other types of reagents can also be utilized for this particular reaction. An example for this can be cyclohexanone, when reacted with phenyl selenohydride in presence of Lewis acid, will give a diselenide, that is selenoacetal. This selenoacetal with N-butyl lithium and carbon dioxide . It will be giving us a carboxylate. This upon oxidation with H2O2 will form a selenoxide. One of the hydrogens is lost. Alpha beta unsaturated acid. Alpha beta unsaturated acid can be easily obtained from this particular reaction. From cyclohexanone, we can create this reaction. So, such reactions can easily be carried out using selenium. These are the applications of selenium or organoselenium reagents. This was our portion for this particular unit, that is paper 2, unit 4.